This is a 1 terabyte micro SD card. It's insane that we can fit so much data onto something small enough to eat. This, on the other hand, is a floppy disk, or what some of you might call the save button. It holds 1.44 megabytes of space, but how many of these could equal this? Well, let me tell you. Well, for $1.5 million, we acquired 700,000 floppy disks. Look how glorious this stack is, it's so tall.
I don't know, man, this seems really unstable. I think it might fall.
I mean, it might, but you know what? It's not real, we'll be fine. Come with me on a journey into the past and the future as I use visual effects and accurate math to show you something you've never seen before. The true scale of data.
No, no,
no! Most of you are probably familiar with memory cards. We put them in our cameras to store the photos and videos that we capture, such as the EOS R10, because this portion of the video is sponsored by Canon. Are you a creator looking to up your game? Well, guess what? The Canon EOS R10 is a pretty great camera. Canon took the best features of their R series and put them in a super lightweight body like this. Dude, so lightweight. But you're like, ah, this is 2022. I want high resolution. Well, guess what? You get it. This shoots 4K video, and if you're shooting photos, 24.2 megapixel stills. I got my own start in film using a Canon camera a lot like this, and this is so much better. For one thing, the autofocus is lightning fast. You literally just like point at anything and it's already focused before your brain even knows what had happened. It's a mirrorless camera and it pairs so nicely with Canon RF lenses. Also, this thing will actually shoot for longer than 30 minutes. I've been using these types of cameras for long enough that like, that's actually a big deal. If you are interested, click that link down in the description to check out the Canon EOS R10. Thanks to Canon again for sponsoring this portion of the video, but let's get back to the episode because I want to show you my first memory card. About 15 years ago, I invested in a massive 1 gigabyte memory card for my camera, which was a big deal back then for a kid like me. However, these days, if I saw one on the street next to a quarter, I'll be honest, I'm probably more likely to pick up the quarter. A gig just doesn't really have much value anymore. It's hard for me to wrap my head around the fact that although these are roughly similar in size, one holds 1,000 times more than the other. I mean, imagine showing this to a computer scientist 60 years ago. It'd blow their minds.
A computer that can fit into a single room and hold millions of pieces of information.
Jesus.
The scale of just how big our data storage has gotten is nearly impossible to imagine. It's that big. So, megabytes, gigabytes, you probably already understand these terms, but do you know what a zettabyte is? These terms help us deal with huge numbers by putting them into groups of 1,000. So 1,000 bytes is a kilobyte, 1,000 kilobytes
is a megabyte, 1,000 megabytes is a gigabyte, 1,000 gigs is a terabyte.
You get the idea. But what's above this? Well, it goes petabyte, then exabyte, then zettabyte, which is 1 billion terabytes. This is literally incomprehensibly large, but don't worry. We'll revisit zettabytes before this video is over. It's easy to take for granted that we stream pretty much everything we want when we want it, but that wasn't always the case. If you wanted to own movies or music, you needed this, optical storage. This is a 4K Blu-ray, which can hold 50 gigabytes per disc. So with only a small stack of 20, I have 1 terabyte. DVDs, on the other hand, they only hold 5 gigabytes per disc, so I need 212 of them to do the same thing. These hold the same amount of data, these two different stacks here. And yes, I know the Blu-rays are like black and the DVDs are blue, whatever, I don't get it. What about the CD? Well, at 700 megabytes per compact disc, you end up with a stack about as tall as a person. Oh. This is a lot heavier than it looks. I'm sure some of you've got like a whole terabyte's worth of music CDs stashed away in those little pocket binders. I know, I'm looking at you. Oh gosh.
It's called the compact disc.
Truthfully, I didn't realize the CD first came out back in 1982. That was 40 years ago. For some reason, I feel like it's newer than that. I mean, I was still buying CDs in 2007 when they crossed 200 billion units sold. Maybe it's just hard for my brain to accept that a computer technology can be so integrated into society without ever changing. Let's do a show of hands. How many of you have a CD player in your car? But as with all change, it took a while for the CD to actually like catch on.
In 1994, Bill Gates advertised the value of the kind of brand new but invented 12 years ago technology by sitting on 330,000 sheets of paper.
The idea is actually very similar to this video. He demonstrated you could store thousands of books worth of information in the palm of his hand. Look at all the paper I'm saving, says the guy literally wasting paper. The photo was taken 28 years ago, so I think it's time to update the comparison. However, instead of holding a CD, I'm gonna be holding a 1 terabyte memory card. So now the question is, how tall is the paper gonna be? Well, if we assume William's calculations are correct, a sheet of paper can hold 2.12 kilobytes of information. Now, I can easily afford the 470 million pages of paper, but no one could give me an answer on how to safely hold me steady at 26 kilometers altitude. They said it was like too dangerous or something stupid like that. Man, I was really looking forward to chilling at the cruising altitude of the SR-71. So why was the CD such a big deal? Well, it marked the change to optical storage from magnetic storage. Have you ever seen what's inside of a floppy disk? It's basically the same kind of stuff as what's inside a VHS and cassette tape because it stores data magnetically. But the data here is coiled into a spiral disk, hence floppy disk. This is the form factor most of us are familiar with, but they actually started out way larger and held way less. And inside of these hard plastic shells, they were indeed floppy. The shells helped to prevent dirt from becoming a problem. 1.44 megabytes is all that these things held. That's not even enough to hold the average amount of data a person generates every single second. During the space age of NASA, scientists had to get creative with how to store memory. They used these hand-woven bits of wire and carbon rings called core memory. How did it work? I actually honestly have no idea. Hey, I'm sorry, I'm a mechanical engineer, not electrical. But according to Scott Manley, it could fit a few terabytes worth of core memory into the actual buildings used to build rockets. This right here is a single bit given to me by Adam Savage when I visited his shop earlier this year. It was invented for the IBM 604, a computer so advanced it could do subtraction plus multiplication and division. State of the art stuff back then. A bit is the smallest form of data possible. It can only store on or off, yes or no, one or zero. It's binary, which means to hold any useful amount of information, you need 8 of them to store a single byte. This right here is just enough hardware to contain the information of a single character of text. We know that a sheet of paper can hold a couple kilobytes of data. At 8 bits per byte, that means 17,000 bits can hold the same information as this. Suddenly a piece of paper seems pretty dang efficient, huh? But what would a terabyte look like? This is 8 trillion bits. Years ago, a terabyte was challenging. But honestly, these days, it's kind of nothing. I mean, our studio deals with hundreds of terabytes. In fact, I think the server we have here at Corridor is the biggest on YouTube.
Maybe not the biggest, but we've all got to start somewhere, right?
Oh, okay, yeah, no, that's pretty big. Yeah, I mean, it isn't that big though. Not that I'm jealous or anything. A petabyte is just one step above a terabyte, so Linus's server is really 2,500 terabytes in size, which I happen to have right here. Now these are all 3D printed because my order of 2,500 micro SD cards got lost in the mail. In theory though, this is how big Linus's server could be. So Linus, what are you doing, man? Wasting all that space? Come on. This is actually very satisfying. Fun fact though, this is around the same data capacity as our brains. Seriously, add up all the synapses, it's about 2.5 petabytes. So now I'm just wondering, why doesn't Linus use this as his server?
You're actually not the first to think of using a pile of commodity SD cards to build out a storage array. In fact, we did a video about it 4.5 years ago. Unfortunately, there are a number of problems with this approach. First and foremost being that it's just not cost effective. A 1 terabyte SD card, that's affordable enough that large video productions would generally consider them to be disposable. 1,000 of them? Yeah. Not so much. That's about 9 times the cost of a petabyte of traditional mechanical hard drives. A hard drive, or even a regular SSD, will often begin spitting out errors weeks or even months before it dies outright, giving you time to hopefully back up your data. SD cards? Well, they just die. And with 1,000+ of these things, you are pretty much guaranteed to have regular failures and the maintenance that goes along with them. At that point, why wouldn't you just buy proper SSDs or hard drives in the first place, right?
But we have all these massive corporations creating dozens of massive multi-billion dollar data centers to host all of your content. And this network of hard drives is called the cloud.
Here it is. This is your future.
But where
where's the fun in that? I mean, I bet they'd save so much space with all these.
Unfortunately, these companies are so secretive about their data capacity, they even hide the exact size and power consumption of their data centers, so we can't even extrapolate how many hard drives they must have.
John?
John?
John!
I tried to hire someone to sneak into a data center for me to find out, but no, apparently that's illegal, or whatever that means. So no, I don't know exactly how many hard drives make up the cloud of one of these companies. However, I do think they're each in the ballpark of around 30 exabytes. If they're not there now, they will be very soon, trust me. That's 30,000 petabytes, or 30 million terabytes. If they used micro SD cards, they could condense their entire cloud into just this. See, they're wasting so much space when they could just have this and call it a day. Come on, guys, if you need any help, I've got extras.
Okay, it wouldn't be a scale video if I didn't show you the max. What's the total amount of data storage in the entire world? Again, it's kind of a tricky number to find. There's a difference between the amount of data being generated, replicated, and deleted, and the actual installed data capacity. Crazily enough, 90% of all data never ends up getting saved.
But if you were to count up all of the hard drives, memory cards, phones, smart hot tubs, and everything else in 2022, we would end up with 10 zettabytes. See, I told you we'd come back to zettabytes.
10 zettabytes is 10 billion terabytes. And a billion is already such a huge number, I made a whole video about it. So 10 billion memory cards? Well, it cost over $1 trillion. And here it is, 10 billion memory cards. Yeah, that's right, they fit in a single tennis court. That is a lot of memory cards, but I don't know, I guess I was just kind of expecting it to be a lot larger. After all, this does hold the entire world's data. It's really a testament to how insanely data-dense memory cards have become. It's almost disappointing, because I wanted something truly gargantuan to show you, but it's probably a bad idea to get a little crazy, isn't it? Hell no, it's not a bad idea. That's right, we're going there. I had to know the bits. 80 billion trillion of these could store everything. And it should be arriving right about now.
This celestial bit is so large that its own gravity takes over, collapsing itself into a mini moon 2,500 kilometers wide. This thing is 4 million times larger than the asteroid that ended the dinosaurs.
A planet killer or a tennis court? Both contain the same amount of information, just in very different ways. It seems like we can't possibly get more data dense than this, but let's not forget the ultimate data storage technology. DNA, because a double helix strand of human DNA contains 215 petabytes of information. But that's just one. We have 1.7 quadrillion strands of DNA in our bodies. You thought 10 zettabytes was big? Try 370 billion zettabytes. That's the data capacity we each carry with us every day because we are the ultimate thumb drives. I think technology still has a long way to go before beating biology. I hope. Thank you so much for watching. It feels great to be making these videos again. I even made a whole playlist of the entire Scale of Science series for your viewing convenience right here. I guess I'll see you next time when I visualize the scale of nuclear explosions. But for now, I'm gonna get back to our quarter digital live stream every month. Hi, I'm back. It holds 1.4 megabytes of space. So how many of...